Welcome back. In the last video, we discussed bistability and hysteresis in cell cycle. In this video, I will discuss how bistability in a transcriptional circuit increases gene expression heterogeneity. Here is a small transcriptional circuit. It is composed of two proteins, L and T. We have designed the system in such a way that these proteins inhibit each other's expression. For example, L could be LacI and T is TetR. We can place the TetR gene under the control of a Lac operon so that LacI will inhibit its expression. So this is a system of mutual repressors. These two repressors could be modulated using external signals I and S. For example, you can use IPTG to modulate the Lac operon, whereas tetracycline could be used to control the repression by TetR. L is fused to GFP so that we can measure the level of expression by flow cytometry. Here is our system of ODEs for this system. We will perform bifurcation analysis with respect to S, the inhibitor of T. So S is the control parameter. Here I have shown the bifurcation diagram for L. The blue lines are for stable steady states and the yellow one is for unstable one. This has two saddle node bifurcation points, S1 and S2. Between S1 and S2, the system is bistable. For one stable steady state, L has high expression, and in the other, the expression of L is very low. Suppose we have created a genetically modified E. coli with this mutual repressor circuit. Now we grow the E. coli in a flask and then add S. Say the dose of S is equal to 5. And then we wait for some time so that the gene expression reaches a steady state. For this value of S, the system is monostable with very low expression of L. So if we analyze those cells by flow cytometry, we will get a very low fluorescence. But will all the cells have the same fluorescence? In other words, will all the cells in the flask have the same amount of L? Not really. Our model is deterministic. But let me remind you that gene expression in an individual cell is a stochastic process. Further, each cell will not receive the same amount of S. That will also add to the stochasticity in expression of L. So the expression of L in an individual cell will fluctuate around a mean. And our deterministic model gives that mean value only. That is why in flow cytometry, we will get a distribution for the fluorescence in cells. Usually, we represent such data as a histogram. So suppose this is the distribution of expression of L when S is equal to 5. This distribution is unimodal. For a very high dose of S, say S equal to 28, the system is monostable with very high expression of L. So we will again get a unimodal distribution in flow cytometry, but with a high mean. Now what will happen in the bistable region? Suppose initially S is equal to 5. Then we increased the dose of S to S equal to 22. This is close to the bifurcation point S2. The cells were earlier at the lower steady state. Following the deterministic behavior on a phage portrait, all cells should stay at the lower steady state even at S equal to 22. However, that will not happen. Some cells will move to the higher stable steady state due to the stochastic fluctuations. So we will have a mixed population with a large difference in expression of L. That heterogeneity will be captured in flow cytometry. We will have two subpopulations, one with high expression of L and another with low expression. This distribution has two modes. Therefore, this type of gene expression with two subpopulations is called a bimodal expression. Bimodality in gene expression due to bistability has been shown in many experimental systems. In the last video, we have shown that a bistable system can have hysteresis. Hysteresis has been experimentally observed in transcriptional circuits with bistability. Some transcriptional network can be multistable. I mean more than two stable steady states. Bistable or multistable systems increases cellular heterogeneity and give rise to subpopulations. Due to bifurcation, an external signal can move the cell population from homogeneous to heterogeneous. Depending upon the function of the gene, each subpopulation may also show different phenotypic behavior. For example, one subpopulation could be more drug resistant than the other. So, a seemingly simple system with bistability could give rise to phenotypic or functional diversity within a population of cells. That's all for this video. I hope this example and the previous one have impressed you regarding the importance of bifurcation in cell biology.